I think we can start the sessions.
Yes, madam.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Shall I start, Vinaya madam and Sheetal madam?
Yes, madam.
A very good morning to one and all. Department of BMS Patkar Verde College welcome you all the students for the student training program on the topic preliminary research. I, Sonali Pilgaonkar, faculty department, you all to our educational institution. Our college was founded by Chikit Samoa and individuals who were keenly interested in education. The college was named after Sir Sitaram Patkar, a distinguished judge of Bombay High Court, who acted after his retirement, and his wife, Lady Shantabai Patkar. Sir Sitaram was deeply interested in furthering the cause of women's education and was the vice chancellor of SNDT University for many years. The College of Art and Science started functioning from the academic year 1964-65 and the commerce section from the academic year 1980-81. To provide career-based education, the college started degree level self-finance courses from the year 2000-2001. Since then, the college has constantly upgraded the courses offered and the infrastructure required for these courses to provide students with the best possible learning opportunities. Many of our alumni hold very good position in various fields. Patkar Verde College has a place of pride amongst the various educational institutions in western suburbs of Mumbai. The college was re-accredited with a score of 3.53 by NAC in 2018 third cycle. Following this, the academic autonomy was also conferred on the college from the academic year 1919-20. And in April 2020, as per the Education World Indian College ranking for 2021, our college was ranked 45th in all over India and 10th rank in Maharashtra. So now I request Pooja ma'am, faculty of BMS department, to introduce today's resource persons, Dr. Sheetal Patil and Dr. Vinaya Naik. Thank you so much, students. Over to you, Pooja madam.
Thank you, Sonal ma'am. I hope I'm audible enough.
Yes, ma'am, you are.
Let me now introduce our speakers, that is the resource person for the day. Dr. Vinaya Naik, our first resource person. She is the faculty of our BMS department. She is also the coordinator of SAP. She is also the coordinator of soft skills department. Dr. Vinaya Naik has enriched her experience with more than 10 years. Okay, welcome Vinaya Naik. Welcome Dr. Vinaya Naik. Our second resource person is Dr. Sheetal Patil. Dr. Sheetal is a faculty of BMS department. She is the coordinator of Masters of Commerce department of Patkar Verde College. She has done her PhD from University of Mumbai and she has 13 years plus years of experience in teaching in the degree. Welcome Dr. Sheetal Patil.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you. Over to you, Dr. Vinaya Naik.
Thank you, Pooja madam. Good morning, one and all respected faculty members and my dear students. I hope you all are doing good. Before I start, guys, let me just present my screen. Okay, just a minute here. Good morning, everybody. Okay. Just a minute, I think there was some issue. Just a minute, huh? Some glitches there. Just a minute. Just a minute. Yeah. Yes. Good morning, everybody. Well, is the screen visible?
Ma'am, it was visible earlier, but now it's black.
Yeah, just a minute. I think there is a glitch, I think, from my end. One more minute. Yeah.
Do you want me to present, Vinaya ma'am?
No, it's okay. It'll be fine. No issues. All right, guys. I'll share the entire screen. Okay. I think now this message you have got, the screen is presenting.
Yes, visible, ma'am.
All right, perfect. So, guys, agenda for the day. We will be talking about. So, welcome you all, guys, on this 3-day educational tour, student training program on preliminary research. Agenda for the day, guys, I'll be talking about introduction to research. And, you know, Sheetal Madam will be talking about concepts in research. Let's go further. Before I start, guys, I want everyone to see the image here. What do you guys see on the image? We see two girls, right? Okay. Image A, we can see a girl who is like pretty quiet as per the picture, in that case, wearing glasses with decent long dress out there, okay? When we see the image B, a girl wearing short skirt, high heels out there, and she has highlighted hair, and she also may have tattoos. It's not visible, all right? Okay, so guys, students, you will have to tell me who with this particular image which you see, who is the topper of the class with respect to the studies? I'll repeat my question. With respect to the image A and image B, I want you guys to tell me who is the topper of the class. I'll come back to the main screen now. All right. Okay. I believe I'm getting a lot of answers here, and all the answers talks about Shiley saying both can be, but majority of the answers are A. Isn't it, guys? All right. Can anyone just unmute yourself and say, aapko kyun A lagta hai? I can probably ask from the chats which I have received. Sonali? Sonali, you are there? Sonali Manjrekar? Can you please unmute yourself? Okay, I'm not getting an answer. Sarvesh Shinde? Sarvesh Shinde? Sheetal Madam, I hope I'm audible, no?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Yeah, thank you. All right.
They might be typing in the chat box, and the chat box might be going up.
True, true. Yes, guys, what do you think? Why it is A? Bhavika, can you unmute, dear?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Bhavika. Can you tell me, आपने image A बोला है, so what do you think? What is your perception here?
According to me, the girl in image A seems to be decent, quite mm-hmm. with glasses, who is padaku type, and mm-hmm. she can score good marks in examination.
Perfect answer, guys. All right. So now majority for that, my audience out here will certainly the answer is image A, as you guys have answered. Image A is a topper of the class. But don't you think these are our own thoughts? Thinking, you cannot prove that image A is topper of the class out there to the world. You're getting it, everyone? Because when you have to prove something, what do you need? You need some evidences for which that's what we call research methodology, everyone. So we can probably convince our friends, you know, that image A is topper. But how are you going to convince the whole world? For that, that's the reason, guys, we need to do research here. With this, let me start my presentation here. The next slide here talks about research methodology. The complete picture here talks about mind map, guys. When we talk about mind map, it is a diagram, you know, used to visualize, organize information out there. It talks about hierarchies. It talks about relationship with various pieces of the complete research. When I say research methodology, we talk about what is research, types of research. There we have basic, applied, then research problem. What is research design? What exactly is sampling? What is measurement and scaling techniques? Data collection, methods of data collection, analysis of data, hypothesis, and tools out there. Okay? This is all we talk about mind map, guys. These are nothing but the components of research methodology. Let's go further. Now, I have a question to everyone here. According to you guys, what is your understanding when I say research? What do you think? What is research? If you want, you can also unmute yourself for answer. Else, you can write in the chat box as well. Very good. Finding out, to find something, research to find something about a topic, true. Anything more? Studying something, yes. Depth of something, knowing in a better way, completely true. To go in deep, to find and study something, working out something before conclusion, perfect. To study about a topic in a detailed and precise manner, dig more into a topic. That's completely right, guys. Okay? So when we talk about research, in common language, in common parlance, it refers to, you know, a search for a knowledge, guys. One can also define research as systematic and scientific search for pertinent information on a specific topic, as you guys have said completely. According to Clifford Woody, author, you know, research talks about defining and redefining problems, formulating hypotheses, suggesting solutions, collecting, organizing, and evaluating data, making deductions out there, and reaching conclusions, also known as inferences. When we talk about, So when we say research, it is an original contribution to the existing stock of knowledge. There is something which is already done, but I am doing further enhancements over the same, advancements out there with respect to the same topic. So research, search for knowledge through objective and systematic method of finding solutions to a problem is research. We do use scientific techniques and methods to complete the research. Next question, guys. Why do we do research? As it is highlighted on the screen, we do research certainly to gain the knowledge. We have some knowledge, but I need to gain extra knowledge. I need to verify some existing knowledge and find solutions to some problems out there in the existing knowledge being searched. When we say research, we talk about identifying, evaluating, establishing further relationship with the variables, which we'll be seeing in the next session. When we talk about research, there is something called as cause and effect relationship. If you can see here, All right. So when I say cause and effect relationship is a relationship in which an event that is called as a cause makes another event happen, and that another event which happens is called as the effect. One cause, one program may have multiple effects. That is also known as outcomes out there. We talk about independent, dependent, and controlled variables, which you'll be seeing in the next session. For example, okay, if we eat too much food and do not exercise, the situation right now, what will happen? We are going to gain weight. True, guys. Okay, so eating food without exercising is nothing but the cause. Weight gain is the effect. All right, I'll come again. The example was, if we eat too much food and we do not exercise, what will happen, guys? We will obviously gain weight. So what is the cause here? Eating food without exercising is the cause. And what is the effect? Weight gain is the effect, which we don't want. No doubt there can be multiple causes and multiple effects. The cause will always occur before the effect. Whenever the cause occurs, the effect will also occur. All right, let's go further, students. Let us understand, you know, in the basic structure of research. I'm sorry, yeah. When we say the basic structure of research, research certainly comprises of conceptual study, also known as theoretical study, and statistical analysis out there. When I say conceptual, theoretical, it is nothing but the methodology, you know, wherein research is controlled by observing and analyzing already present information on a given topic. When I say conceptual research, it is conducted by observing and analyzing already present information on a given topic. It is certainly related to abstract concepts and ideas for that matter. Philosophers, you know, they use conceptual research to develop new theories or interpret existing theories as well in a different light. Let me just give an example here. You all may be knowing the famous example, you know, Sir Isaac Newton researcher. He certainly observed his surroundings to conceptualize and develop theories. We all know about gravitation and motion. That is called as conceptual theory, guys. Okay? Yeah. Let's go further. We talk about statistical, as the word talks about statistics. We, you know, here we talk about carrying out a study which talks about planning, designing, collecting data, analyzing, drawing meaningful interpretation, and reporting of the research findings out there. When I say statistical, we always dimag mein kya aata statistics yaad aaya to? When we talk about statistics, what comes in your mind? Very good, Sanjam. You're to the point. Numbers. Completely right, guys. Okay? When I say statistics, I talk about numbers, guys. Thereby bringing life to a meaningful data or a lifeless data at times. We talk about company reports. Okay? They all talk about statistical analysis there. I believe this particular research part is clear to everyone. Completely true, Shruti. Figures, graph, true. Next. All right. Yeah. Thank you very much. Before I go further, I have a question to everyone, guys. अभी हम लॉकडाउन में यूजुअली क्या करते हैं वी ऑल नो वी अटेंड लेक्चर्स आई कंप्लीटली अग्री टू एवरी वन यू नो यू अटेंड ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स थैंक यू वेरी मच अदर देन ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स व्हाट एल्स व्हाट डू वी डू आफ्टर लेक्चर्स ओके व्हाट डू वी डू करिकुलम फेयर एनाफ पढ़ाई वढ़ाई करेंगे इंप्रूविंग आवर सेल्फ इन फ्री टाइम वेरी गुड श्रुति नेटफ्लिक्स एंड चिल वेरी गुड श्रीरा यू आर टू द पॉइंट गो फॉर अ वॉक एंड कोर्स इज कंप्लीटली राइट ट्रू एक्सरसाइज यस नीड ऑफ द आवर ओके नेटफ्लिक्स वाला एग्जांपल है हम लोग मूवीज तो देखते रहेंगे ना वर्क्स ऑन आवर स्किल्स ट्रू अविनाश वेरी गुड हम मूवीज देखते हैं चलो रिसेंटली कौन सा मूवी देखा आप लोग ने जरा अनम्यूट करके बात करिए ना स्टूडेंट्स आई नो आप लोग को आदत है विद द चैटिंग आउट देयर वेरी इफेक्टिव ऑल्सो ना आपका टाइपिंग स्पीड ही बढ़ गया रहेगा ना इजंट इट बिकॉज ऑफ द कोविड ट्रू Yes, Shreera, can you unmute yourself? Shreera, you're there? ओके अनम्यूट आप कर सकते हो, योर माइक इज फाइन। नो, यस, व्हाट इज इट? ओके योर माइक इशू, फेयर इनफ। सो नेटफ्लिक्स में हम लोग मूवीज देखते हैं। आई एक्चुअली वॉन्टेड टू टॉक टू समवन, नाउ हु डू आई कॉल? ओके All right, Feza. Feza, you're there? Or Siley as well. Can you guys unmute yourself? Okay, Akash is saying web series. Yes, true. So we see movies, right? True. हम पूरे दिन में कभी ना कभी कुछ ना कुछ मूवीज देखेंगे, शॉर्ट फिल्म्स भी सी, वी वुड सी विद सम एड्स इन दैट केस। ऑल राइट, सो गाइज, कैन यू जस्ट टेल मी लाइक वॉट कुड बी द स्टेप्स ऑफ और द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग मूवीज? श्रीरा, यू कैन ऑल्सो टाइप एंड लेट मी नो, ओके, एज योर माइक इज नॉट वर्किंग। स्माइली, यस आकाश, गो एड। वॉट आर द स्टेप्स ऑफ मेकिंग अ मूवी
हेलो
और
मैम, एम
प्रोसेस
आई
ऑफ
ऑडिबल?
मेकिंग? यस
द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग मूवी मीन्स मैम, फर्स्ट मीन्स मैम, यू आर आस्किंग दैट हाउ द कास्टिंग एंड ऑल, और डायरेक्टली आफ्टर द मूवी इज मेड हाउ इट इज बीइंग लॉन्च्ड?
In short, what could be the steps of movie? In short.
फर्स्ट मैम, द स्क्रिप्टेड स्टोरी इज बीइंग एनालाइज्ड बाय द डायरेक्टर एंड द प्रोड्यूसर। देन सेकंड स्टेप, एज पर दैट स्क्रिप्ट एंड दे टेक द ऑडिशंस ऑफ द पीपल हु कैन फिट इन दैट रोल एग्जैक्टली।
Okay.
Then second step, all the locations and all are finalized by the director in
All
2 to 3 months somewhat, and then the budgets and all are finalized, and then shooting gets started.
Okay.
And then, ma'am, after the shoot ends, the first the production house keep editing and all work done by them, and then it goes to the government CF certificate, which is being authorized to a movie.
All right.
Then all the picture is finalized, and then it's being released in the theaters.
Okay, perfect. Anyone else would like to say something? Something different? Can unmute themselves. Siley, you're there? You were saying, I think. Akash just say it started, so I think you mute yourself. Siley, you're there? Okay, I'm not getting a
Yes,
reply
yes.
here. Okay, huh. Yes, Eileen.
Just a second. Ma'am, first we have a development like project various and project script. Like we have to brief a book or a story outline.
Okay. All right.
Director or writing, pitching an idea to a producer. Then we
Okay.
have to pre-production.
Very good. So I
Then
believe. Yes, Ali, go ahead.
production. In short, all parties are involved, like location, set, office, production company, distributors.
Wonderful. Brainstorming to come up with a good relatable concept. Yes, Anjum. So I believe you all can get into the movie production. You all can become producers, isn't it? So much experiences we have gained rather in a year. Yeah, Shriram. Thank you very much.
Vinaya ma'am, sorry to disturb you in between.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, there are some students who wanted to join because there were so many participants for our webinar. So, you know, there is one more link which Sonal madam has sent. So, I think you will have to join. Just take a call of Sonal madam. And just participants, please be patient. We will be continuing with the session, but there are some more students also in the line, so we are just arranging that. So just be patient.
Fine, fine. I'll log in there.
Okay, work with Sonal madam also.
Yes.
Yeah.
Vinaya madam, I have created one more link.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That is from the SYB. You have to just join that link. And you have to present on both the screens.
I got that. I'll do that.
Okay.
It is STP research, kya?
From B division. Yes, correct.
STP research, na? Haan?
Yes. Right.
Okay. Ek minute de do.
Vinay ma'am, you have to mute one meet and keep one mute.
Fine, I'll do that. I'll mute. I didn't get you. Come again, Shital madam.
SYA, you mute, and the current one which you are doing, you keep your mic on so that it will be listenable to everyone. And your voice on the echo.
Okay. I got that. I've joined the other meet as well, right?
Yes, you have joined it. Yes.
Yeah.
And you present your screen from both the places.
Yes.
Check with those students that whether they are able to listen.
Madam?
Yes.
I'll call you. 1 minute.
Yeah. Okay. You're not audible over here.
Yeah, I'm sorry, madam.
Now proper.
Yes, thank you, Faiza.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you, madam. So, you know, I asked the... No. It is just a normal movie, guys. I just asked the same question to the earlier students, you know. Ki ek movie rahega. Any movie, short film, anything. What could be the basic steps for making a movie? That's what the question was of mine. Can you just let me know? One team has already, you know... Yeah, perfect, Srirag. Yes. You can message if you want. Janesh, you can also unmute yourself and say.
And the short film should give a message it would be of just 10 or 15 minutes. So there should be a strong message through that short video.
Okay. All right. Anything more? Guys, when we talk about movie making, okay? So we have a concept, we have a script, we have the cast location, we have the shoot, we have editing. I believe I'm audible at both the places, yeah. Then we have effects, color correction.
Vinaya madam, you are audible properly at both the places. Vinaya madam, you are not audible over here.
A glitch here. All right. I request everyone, you can probably type the messages in the chat only. You're good to go.
In between, we lost the conversation, what you were speaking, because here you weren't audible at all.
Yes, ma'am. I'll come back again, okay?
Yeah.
I'm just talking about, I believe, both the places I'm audible now.
Yes, here you're audible.
All right. Thank you. So, you know, we were talking about, yes, Isha has also mentioned here about plan the concept, making it appealing to equally, add songs, better understanding, editing, shoot and promotions. That's completely true. So, in the very same manner, jaise hum movies banate hai, guys, vaisa hi research ke bhi steps hote hai. Okay, that's the reason why I asked the question to everyone. The way we make movies, in the very same manner, research is also conducted. Okay, research may be concept hoga, research may be scripting hoga. Okay, naam alag rahega. Understanding the terminology which is used in research for scripting may be different. It may be called as ROL, review of literature, or something else also. Casting, location, obviously, right now, because of the pandemic situation, we do it research online, Google Meet. Otherwise, when we have to do research, many other researchers, different types of researchers, they have to go to locations and do the research. Shoots, editing is always there. Effects happen. The way you like write the research process. I request everyone to be on mute. The color corrections, finale cut, and the distribution, and the final theater or the final research project. Okay, I'm gonna present my screen. I've already presented. I think I'll start the explanation part. Madam, is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you.
You are having an echo, huh? Just take care.
Yes, ma'am.
So let's go ahead with the steps in research process. When we talk about the first step, is a movie mein humne dekha tha na, waisa hi selecting the topic out there. Students, research topics should be from your interest area. One can choose topics from their area of specialization as well. When we say topic selection, you know, you need to have something called as a broad area and a sub area. Okay? So when we talk about, you know, researchers, they need to check their ROL, review of literature, while topic selections for further advancements in the research. When we talk about approval of the topic, obviously, you know, jab hum research karte, for example, jab aap log bhi research karoge, you will take help from your faculties. You will be help taking, for example, when I was doing my research in PhD, we have a guide, you know, so we probably take help from them. And, you know, we probably just check out hamara broad area, sub area, perfect hai ya nahi. If I give you my own example, students, my PhD topic of research was about social entrepreneurship. Now, social entrepreneurship is the sub area. When I say broad area, that is entrepreneurship. I believe the message is clear to all. Okay. Next, we talk about here is the ROL, review of literature. What is a review of literature? It is a comprehensive summary of previous researchers being done on a specific topic which you have selected. Review of literature is a comprehensive summary of previous researchers being done on a particular topic. हम लोग मूवी का एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं. बहुत सारे मूवीज तो यू नो कहीं ना कहीं वो लोग पहले का, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू नो दे टेक सम अदर मूवी इन सम अदर लैंग्वेज रीजनल एंड दे प्रॉब्ली यू नो उसको डब करके वो लोग इंग्लिश मूवीज इंग्लिश नहीं हिंदी मूवी बनाते हैं. Alright, even English movies can be made or any specific movie, I can rather say. But we take some references. Kabhi kabhi, you know, hum log koi article ka ya books ka reference lete. Koi, you know, on a ek book, for example, Half Girlfriend wala. You're getting it? I'm not really sure the movie is right. Arjun Kapoor was there, that I know, and Shraddha. So, you know, just an example I'm giving you. Review of literature bhi to same hi hota hai, guys. Review of literature kya hai? We actually, you know, take previous researchers being already done on a particular topic, hum usko samajhte hain and uske hisab se apna topic ko leke we rather go ahead, we rather, you know, do research on it. Then we talk about gap analysis. It is nothing but gaps are what assessing the differences, gaps called as differences between the actual performance and the expected performance in an organization or a business. When I say gap analysis, it also has to be referred to as need analysis for that matter. Swati madam, good to go. Okay. So formulation of hypothesis is the next part. Hypothesis, when I say it is used as a phenomenon to predict a relationship in that case. All right. So relationship and communication research, formulating a hypothesis requires specific testable and predictable statements driven by theoretical guidances out here. When we talk about the next is setting of objectives of the study. Scripting is what, guys? Setting the objective of the study only. Movie mein jab scripting bolte na storyboard, kya karta hai wo objective set karta hai apne movie ka. Aisa hoga, ye mera story rahega. So research objectives describe concisely what the research is trying to achieve in that case at the end of the day. They will summarize the accomplishments a researcher wishes to achieve. They will summarize, you know, how exactly, you know, I would rather come to the conclusion of my study. Research objectives, okay? Next, we talk about setting the questionnaire. Swati madam, I'm audible, right? So when I say setting the questionnaire out there, I'm so sorry. I need to understand my question should be in logical manner, asked one question at a time. Make sure you have, you know, like open-ended questions at, depending upon the research. Use a simple visual design so that you understand, you know, the common individuals can understand what you want to ask the question. Create question with straightforward, unbiased language. Then we talk about determining the sampling methods. There are multiple types of sampling. We talk about simple random sampling, systematic sampling, snowball sampling, etc. It will be discussed in the further sessions of ours. We need to also understand the sampling size there. Sample size is what? It is determination of the number of observations which make a particular sample complete. Sample size is an important feature of any empirical study. Wherein, wo sample size se mujhe mera inferences milta hai, guys. Okay? I believe I had mentioned what do you mean by inferences. Inferences means nothing but conclusions out there. I believe I'm clear with everyone. All right? So when I say inferences, I mean nothing but conclusions, guys. We come to a conclusions based on evidences. All right? Yeah. Go back to my screen here, slide. Yeah. Sample size is done. Then we talk about data collection. Data collection is what? It is a procedure of collecting and measuring and analyzing the data. I'm going to collect, measure, and analyze accurate insights for research using standard validated techniques there. A researcher can evaluate their hypothesis based on the collected data. When we talk about, you know, data, okay, let me come back to the screen here. So data, we talk about primary and secondary. Okay. So when I say data, I'm talking about, sorry, primary and secondary. When I say primary data, students, primary data is what? It is the first-hand information, original data. Examples de deti hu aapko, surveys and group discussions. Aapne question pucha, bahut samne aapko answer milta hai. Getting it, everyone? When I talk about secondary data, information is already collected by someone in the past. Kaise milta information already collected by someone in the past? Internet, articles, reports, company reports, information, google.com. Yes? Perfect. Next, we talk about data editing and cleaning. Movie banate waqt maine aapko bataya tha, yaad hai? When I'm making a movie, तब मैं एडिटिंग करता हूँ. एडिटिंग इज सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मूवीज, यू नो, इफेक्ट डालता हूँ. दैट इज व्हाट वी डू इन रिसर्च प्रोसेस एज वेल, गाइस. वी हैव टू डू डेटा एडिटिंग एंड क्लीनिंग. व्हेन आई से डेटा क्लीनिंग, इट इन्वॉल्व्स डिटेक्शन एंड रिमूवल एंड करेक्शन ऑफ एरर्स एंड इनकन्सिस्टेंसीज इन माई डेटा सेट एंड डेटा बेस ड्यू टू, यू नो, करप्शन और एनी इनएक्यूरेट एंट्री ऑफ द डेटा. कभी कभी हो जाता है मिस्टेक्स बाय माई ऑडियंसेज, यू नो. ऑडियंस बोलते, अरे मैंने ना गलती से कुछ और टाइप किया था, मुझे टाइप कुछ और करना था. सो वी प्रोबेबली एडिट एंड डिस्कार्ड दैट डेटा इन दैट केस. वी डू डेटा क्लीनिंग इट एज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ इंश्योरिंग दैट योर डेटा इज करेक्ट. डेटा एडिटिंग इज डन कि मेरा डेटा कंसिस्टेंट होना चाहिए एंड यूजेबल होना चाहिए रिसर्च के लिए. जब भी हम लोग right now we don't go, guys, but many a times before COVID we all have been to malls. Yes, before COVID. Before COVID abhi nahi bol rahi. So kabhi aapne aise kuch experience kiya hai wherein someone would rather, you know, tell you to fill something out there about a particular review you have to give about a particular product and services in that case, any feedback form, anything out there, any experiences you have done? Surveys, completely true. Anything it could be. Ab kabhi kabhi hum log na Vijay Sales jaate hain, kuch aise Croma jaate hain. So you have not purchased, but still, you know, they would rather, you know, talk to you directly. Primary data out there. They would rather give you something to, you know, fill it out there. Secondary data there. Even sorry, even a primary data इसमें भी आता है when we take the surveys and everything that will also that will actually come in the primary data only. But then when we talk about you know these information which is collected, data collection हम करते primary या secondary से, okay? Especially I would talk about primary जब से data collect करते guys. So are you guys 100% sure कि आप 100% बराबर से देख के उसको you complete the data? Or you complete the survey? Or you just do tick, 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 tick. I'm done. I don't have time. No, right? It depends. At times it depends, you know. It depends, actually it depends on the services which you have used. For example, you have gone to a restaurant for a brunch or a lunch or dinner, etc., whatever. And, you know, उन्होंने बोला चलो भाई, we need to take a feedback of yours. आप बहुत खुश हुए. तो आप सामने से बोलेंगे अरे यू नो समथिंग आई रियली लाइक योर सर्विसेज ओके सामने से यू नो यू मे रादर गिव हिम अ टिप डिपेंडिंग ऑन यू डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द कस्टमर बट जस्ट थिंक अबाउट ऑन अ वाइस वर्स अ मैनर इफ यू डिड नॉट लाइक इट एंड उन लोग ने ऐसे कुछ सर्वे वगैरह रखा नहीं है कुछ भी नहीं रखा है बट हम जाके बोलते हैं ना उन लोग को आपको पता है क्या इसमें ये प्रॉब्लम था इसमें ये मिला मुझे डोंट वी डू दैट True, we do that, guys. Okay, why? Because I would rather, you know, I am paying for the services. Even if I am paying 50%, but I am paying there. Nobody is giving me for free out there. I would rather want the services which I am getting to be valuable in the very same manner, students. When we talk about research, the data which I get at the end of the day should be usable for my research. उसको हम valuable बोलते हैं, guys. ऐसे आप डेटा ले लो यार आप बैठ के अपने फ्रेंड्स से बोल दो ना भाई डेटा भर दो नहीं तो आपका रिसर्च वहां पे कंप्लीट नहीं होता है गाइस यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑलराइट या ट्रू वन मिनट आई प्रेजेंट द स्क्रीन नेक्स्ट वी टॉक अबाउट हियर इज वन मिनट आई डोंट नो कुछ तो हुआ हाँ Data analysis. It is a method in which data is collected and organized so that one can derive the helpful information from it. Jaise for example, okay? Starting off my session. Just a minute. I'll have to stop the presentation. Okay. Is the screen visible to all?
Yes, it is, ma'am.
Okay, one minute. One minute. I'll just fix that. Okay, screen visible in. So, जब मेरा start वाला session था ना, जब मैंने आपको बताया था ये image देख के आपको क्या लगता है? Image A and image B. Who is the topper of the class? So, you know, what are we doing here? We are doing observations here. You're getting it, everyone? Okay. So this type of data collection involves, you know, observations and watching, you know, probably giving some review over the same. Okay, yeah. I'm presenting now. Yeah, I believe the screen is visible, yes. So when we in data analysis, you know, we have to take into account the observation part also. The customer behavior, all right? फॉर एग्जाम्पल हमें डेटा तो मिल जाएगा कस्टमर के ऐसे डेटा मुझे मिल जाएगा All right, we can talk about collecting data, collecting the customer data through supermarkets, through smartphone devices for that matter. But I need to analyze the data. That's the crux out there. Next, we'll be talking about hypothesis part. मैंने formulation of hypothesis ये मैं यहाँ पे आपको बताऊंगी what exactly we mean by hypothesis, guys. Okay? We will be talking about testing of hypothesis. When I say hypothesis, it is a statistical test used to measure, you know, to determine whether the hypothesis assumed for a particular sample of data will be true or false. Okay? When I say hypothesis, hypothesis kya hai? It is an assumption, you know. Hypothesis is nothing but an assumption out there. It is an assumption which is tested further to determine the relationship between two data sets. For example, is it true that vitamin C has the ability to cure or prevent the common cold? This is an example. Is it true that a vitamin C has the ability to cure or prevent the common cold? In hypothesis, we talk about two hypotheses, null and alternate. Null and alternative hypothesis. When I say null and alternative hypothesis, so mera hum log ka example kya tha? Is it true that vitamin C has ability to cure or prevent the common cold? Or is it a myth out there? Null hypothesis means children who take vitamin C are no less likely to become ill during flu season. Alternative hypothesis matlab, they are less likely to become ill during the flu season. All right? This is about the hypothesis part. Next, lastly, we talk about preparing reports. Movie mein last mein kaisa hum log theater mein movie jaake dekhte apna movie pura ban jata hai. There are some steps in report writing. We will be talk about, you know, local analysis of the subject matter. We prepare the final outline there. We have a rough draft. We rewrite and polish my reports. We prepare the final bibliography and write the final draft there. This is all about the steps in research process, students. Okay? Next, we will be talking about types of research. First, we'll be talking about basic research, also called as pure and fundamental research. This is done to obviously enhance the knowledge. The main motivation is also called as knowledge expansion. I'll give you some examples to make you understand what is the basic research. An investigation looking at whether stress levels influence how often students engage in academic cheating. Okay? An experiment to determine a simple fact is a basic research. A study which will assess whether men and women are more likely to be diagnosed with depression. A study looking at how caffeine consumption impacts the brain out there. Basic research. When I talk about applied research, as the word itself is apply, I'm going to apply something here. It focuses on analyzing and solving real life problems, you know. When we talk about applied research, it refers to the study of and helps solve practical problems and using some scientific methodology out there. Studies play an important role. For example, finding a specific cure for a disease. आपको देख के लगेगा हाँ आपको cold है ना चलो Vicks की गोली ले लो और Vicks ले लो etc etc. But with the cold, it can be something else. After the diagnosing, we understand it was not a cold, it was COVID in that case. Understanding? Just an example I'm giving you. When we talk about applied research, it is, you know, application of X-ray rays in medicine. Example of applied research. Okay? Problem-oriented research. As the name suggests, problem-oriented is conducted to understand the exact nature of a problem, you know, to find out relevant solutions there. The problem, when I say, it refers to multiple choices or issues when analyzing a situation. For example, revenue of a car company has decreased by 12% in the last year. There could be various issues, you know, causes can be many. There is no optimum production, poor quality of the product, no advertising, economic conditions. They are called as problem-oriented research. Okay, when I say problem-solving research, Here, it is conducted by companies to understand and resolve their own problems. Here, in the problem-solving research, companies also used applied research to come to a solution. Okay, qualitative and quantitative research. Qualitative research, you know, it is a process about inquiry. It helps to create in-depth understanding of problems and issues. It is non-statistical, huh? And non-numerical also. There are no numbers in qualitative research. Method not only helps a researcher understand what the participants think, but also why they think in a particular manner. Wo batata hai qualitative. We ask open-ended questions, you know, which encourages answers to, and you know, these answers can also lead to another set of questions and group of questions which can be asked to the audience out there. Or also called as respondents. The one who respond a questionnaire is called as respondents. In food items, we search better quality. Perfect. Yes, Isha, completely true. Okay. When I say qualitative research, we talk about one-to-one interview is conducted, all right? Where, you know, interviews where a researcher prepare the questions in advance to ask the question to the other person, all right? The interview can last for 20 minutes to an hour, depending upon the situation there. During this time, the researcher will collect as many meaningful answers as possible from the participants to draw inferences, guys. I believe you all know what is the meaning of inferences. Yes, students? I'll get that. I'll come to the point, Aishwarya. Let me just complete, huh? Inference is nothing but conclusions out there. Okay? Yeah. True. Yeah. After one-to-one, we also talk about case study. It is used to study an organization entity. It is one of the most valuable options for the modern research. Okay. Case study also involves a deep dive into ongoing research and collecting data. However, the next research which talks about quantitative research, it deals with numbers, quantity. Quantity ka matlab kya hota hai? Number na? And their measurable form. Qualitative mein mujhe measurable nahi hota hai. I will rather, in qualitative research, you know, it uses a systematic way of investigating events and data. I would get answers in terms of justifying relationship with measurable variables, you know, to either explain, predict, or control a particular phenomenon. Quantitative mein hum na survey and correlational research bol sakte. When I say survey research, the ultimate goal of survey research is to learn about a large population by deploying a survey. Here, online surveys are very much popular as they are convenient. We can rather, you know, send an email and WhatsApp and get the answers in. Correlational research, you know, correlation, as the word itself says, it talks about relationship between two or more variables. We will be considering a researcher who is studying a correlation between a cancer and married women. So, for example, married women may have a negative correlation with cancer. So the two variables jab hum log bolte hain na ye example mein married women have a negative correlation with cancer, the two variables nothing but cancer and married women. Okay, so just an example here. Yeah, with this we complete the session here. Just a minute. Yes, I was asked a question here. Just a minute. Where is the question? Okay, different in problem orientation and problem solving for that matter. Every individual, you know, will approach a particular problem in a different manner. Some will focus on the problem or the reason why a problem has emerged. Getting it, everyone? Okay. So we would rather focus on a particular problem, or we rather would solve the problem. Others will prefer to, you know, possible solve the problem there. Solution focused thinking, we can also tell them. Aishwarya, is the message clear? Problem orientation and problem solving. Hello. Yes, certainly. Conclusion will be for both. Any more questions you have, students? Just check here on the slide. Yeah. This was all about introduction to research, guys. In the next session, which will be taken by Dr. Sheetal Madam, she will be talking about concepts in research. Over to you, Sheetal Madam.
Thank you, Vinaya Ma'am. I'll just make few settings, just a minute, students. Am I causing echo by any chance? Just type in the chat box.
No, madam.
Kindly type in the chat box. I have mute. I have kept speaker off. Okay. One more testing. I'm keeping my speaker on. Now, am I causing any echo? Now?
No.
Okay, great. Fine. So I'll just unmute the video. Give me a minute. Yes, now visible properly. PPT is visible. Okay. Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Sheetal Patil from BMS department. I'll be taking henceforth Dr. Vinaya ma'am have left. She has given you an overview about what is research. Now you all have a hang of. Yes, what is mean by research? What is understand by the word research, the research process, and so many things, right? I have to keep an eye on the chat box too. Hello, everyone. Just a minute. Okay, so hope everything is very clear to you all. Let's now dive into some kind of depth, very crisp about the concepts, which are very essential for doing a research. Okay, madam has given you an overview. Next two days, also we are going to have a depth about what is actually research upon. So let's, without delay, I should go ahead. So this is what concepts of research which I'll be taking today. These are the concepts which we will be learning today is about variables, sample size, sampling design and types, sampling method, just a brief about hypothesis and pilot study, and then research design. Out of which some of the concept you must be definitely knowing as you all are from FY, right? You might have shifted from FY to SY, or you are either in TY, because of which some of the concept which you are already aware about. So I'll be asking questions to you all over there. Okay, so let's begin. Are all ready, or shall I just wait for 2 minutes? Are all ready? I want to see people are ready or not. Shall we continue? Because it was a bit rigorous session. You can have a sip of water, but kindly give an ear to me. Okay, great, fine. So the first concept which you can see here is called as variable. Before I proceed to the concept, to the PPT, can anybody tell me what can be the variable about? What can be variable about? What do you feel? What can be variable? What can be the word variable? Simple, just a random guess. What can be word variable? I know, I don't know. These are the answers. Yes, I know, I don't know. These can be the answers. Be quick. Yes, in terms of some kind of numerical value, right, Isha? Very good. Yes, absolutely, Shruti. Something which is going to change, absolutely. So you all are actually familiar about what is meant by variable. So yes, variable. The word is broken into two parts. It is called as vary and able. The vary means something is going to keep on changing, and able has the ability to change the value. That is called as variable. Okay, so it is a property that takes on the different values. Referring to a definition of variable, we can say that any such characteristics which possess by any living or non-living things, which is going to change the value over a period of time to a particular unit or a group or the study. Such characteristics is called as variable into the study. Okay, and these are the measurable term. We can quantify that. Yes, somebody said that it is quantifiable, right? We can measure that particular terminology. One can manipulate and control. Jaise ki, I want to measure, if I say I want to do a study on online learning abilities among students. So which are the students? Which variable I should take? Should I take students of schools, students of graduate stream or undergraduate or postgraduate or any other kind of student? So this is what a variable, an attribute whose value can change from time to time. The variables can be age, income, motivation, and number of things are there. And the value given to the variable, we call it as attributes. What we call it as attributes. Hum log kya bolte hai usko? Type in the chat box. The value given to the variable is called as attribute. Value given to variable. I hope I am clear. Isse hum log kuch prove nahi karne wale hai. I am not going to test you all. But yes, these are called as attributes. Jo variable hota hai, jiska value change hota hai, that value is called as attributes. I'll just go through the other class too. Yes. Is it clear to the other batch? Variable is means what? A value, an attribute whose value is going to change per time, per unit, per person, per group, etc. That's called as variable. Let's move ahead. We'll keep it up to the mark. Then there are types of variable. Basically, the variable are divided into the two categories, two basic categories, which are called as based on attributes and based on relationship. The relationship which Vinaya ma'am just have explained about the cause and effect relationship. That means the presence of one variable and the presence of other variable are going to affect each other, either in positive way or negative way, or one factor will be dominant, other factor will not be dominant. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, there are attributes based on attributes, which will be in your continuous and non-continuous, and then based on cause and effect are called as independent, dependent, and control. So when I talk about attributes based on attribute, that is your continuous and non-continuous, type in the chat box, what do you mean by continuous variable? Any example? I'm sure you all are aware about. What can be continuous variable? What can be continuous variable? Example, very easy, very simple for you all. What can be continuous variable? Please do type in the chat box. Continuous variable. The word continuous means what? Kya hoga usme value kaisa hoga? Yes, which keeps on going. Yes. Yes, here, the other batch. I'm not able to get the responses. Yes, guys. Please tell me what can be the continuous. Continuous means what? Jiska value increase hoga ya decrease hoga, it must be changing. Yes, Shriraj, absolutely right. A weather fluctuating, temperature fluctuating, age increasing, income increasing or decreasing depending on different factors. Okay, so there is a continuous variable and non-continuous variable. When we say continuous variable, these are also called as discrete variable. Continuous variable ko kya bolte hai? Discrete variable, which involves some kind of numerical value, which is having some kind of info and which is having either increment or decrement. So it is not fixed, which is called as continuous variable. Okay, these are also called as discrete variable. Examples can be your height, weight, miles per hour, or time. That is something which is having a continuity. I hope I'm clear on continuous variable. Yes, the distance too. Absolutely right. Okay, here I think other batches are sleeping, might be. No issues, never mind. Let's move ahead. The non-continuous, which is also called as dichotomous variable. Inko bolte hain non continuous, or we call it as dichotomous variable. I think I have a PPT further. So non-continuous variable are the variable which are not continuous in nature, which do not have an incremental value. It is contrast to your continuous variable, which has a distinct value and it has no precise numerical flow. That means whether it might not be increasing or decreasing. Rather, it would be very fixed into the nature. Example, I think you can see on the screen, that is your age, your gender. In gender, we may have male, female. And aajkal kya aata hai apna? It's mandatory to keep male, female, and what is mandatory we have to keep is about, in case of gender, what we have to also look after जेंडर में कैटेगरीज क्या होंगे, व्हाट कैन बी द कैटेगरीज इन, प्रिफर नॉट टू से, और एक्चुअली वी कैन से दैट ट्रांसजेंडर, और वी कैन से प्रिफर नॉट टू से. यस, सो दिस इज व्हाट समथिंग, यस समथिंग नीड टू बी रिटन इफ यू आर कंडक्टिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ रिसर्च, बिकॉज वी आर मेकिंग इट इंक्लूसिव. ओके, सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट अ नॉन कंटिन्यूअस और डिकोटोमस, दे आर हैविंग दीज एग्जाम्पल्स लाइक जेंडर, एम्प्लॉयमेंट स्टेटस. अभी एम्प्लॉयमेंट क्या है, इधर आई एम एम्प्लॉयड और आई एम नॉट एम्प्लॉयड. If I'm employed, I'm a full-time or I'm a part-time. I'm a contractual or I'm a permanent. These are the maximum option that is called as non-continuous. Are we clear on continuous and non-continuous, dichotomous and discrete variable to everyone? To everyone? Great, great. Very good. Okay, let's move ahead. The second factor, second type of variable, the category of variable which is based on cause and effect relationship. Cause and effect relationship will be basically categorized into four parts, three parts, that is your dependent variable, independent variable, and then called as controlled variable. Now, controlled variable is much more depth into. So let's understand only two very basic ones, which we usually study, which we usually do on a primary level, as our station is very preliminary research. Okay. So in case of preliminary research, we will be learning the two other type of variable called as independent variable and dependent variable. When I say independent variable, the name itself sounds like something which is independent, something which stands alone, and it do not change because of the existence of other parameter. They have their own status. Independent variable have their own status, and they do influence other. मतलब existence of that independent variable will influence other. अभी मैम आप क्या बात करो, आप बात करो dichotomous का, discrete का, independent, dependent, where it is coming into the research. Okay, so if I give you an example of, I'll just make the PPT ahead. See, if this is an example, I'll go again, go back to the previous slide. A study on impact of online learning among undergraduate commerce students of University of Mumbai. Abhi mujhe batao, here in this particular statement, this is a study, okay? Ye ek research ka title hai. Can you see the title? आपको ये टाइटल दिख रहा है? द टाइटल सेज व्हाट, अ स्टडी ऑन इंपैक्ट ऑफ ऑनलाइन लर्निंग अमंग अंडरग्रेजुएट कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मुंबई. अभी मुझे बताओ, ये पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट या ये पर्टिकुलर अगर हम लोग को रिसर्च करना है, अज्यूम हम लोग को एक स्मॉल टास्क दिया मैम ने, ठीक है, आर कोऑर्डिनेटर्स हैव गिवन अस अ टास्क दैट एक रिसर्च कंडक्ट करो कि ये पैंडेमिक में बच्चों को कैसा लगा ऑनलाइन लर्निंग. ओके, सो वेरिन वी हैव टेकन अ टॉपिक एज ऑनलाइन लर्निंग अमंग अंडरग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट. अभी मुझे आप बताओ, यहाँ पे व्हाट कैन बी द एट्रीब्यूट्स हियर, यहाँ पे एट्रीब्यूट्स क्या है, विच ऑल एट्रीब्यूट्स आर हियर, प्लीज टू टाइप इन द चैट बॉक्स, विच ऑल एट्रीब्यूट्स आर हियर इन द चैट बॉक्स, टाइप इन द चैट बॉक्स. ये टाइटल में अ स्टडी ऑन इम्पैक्ट ऑफ ऑनलाइन लर्निंग अमंग अंडरग्रेजुएट कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मुंबई. व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हियर, टेल मी व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हियर. यस, व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हियर, please do type in the chat box. What we are going to study here? Yes, what we are going to study here in this title, I hope you all can see the screen, I hope you all can understand, there is a study, ek title diya hai. Abhi ek title mein, ye research mein kya variables hai, okay here impact, okay, I lost the chat. एक है इम्पैक्ट स्टडी करना, इम्पैक्ट तो है, दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव टू स्टडी, बट इम्पैक्ट ऑन व्हाट, इम्पैक्ट ऑफ ऑनलाइन लर्निंग. यस, सो माय ऑनलाइन लर्निंग इज वन ऑफ द कंपोनेंट, लेट मी जस्ट टाइप इन द चैट बॉक्स, ऑनलाइन लर्निंग, राइट, ये एक मेरा है. और व्हाट एल्स आई एम लर्निंग हियर, व्हाट एल्स आई एम स्टडिंग हियर, ऑनलाइन स्टडी, ऑनलाइन लर्निंग, यस, व्हाट एल्स, इतना ही कर रहा है कि यहाँ पे द टाइटल स्टेज व्हाट, A study on impact of online learning, कौन कर रहा है? Online learning किसके लिए हम लोग study कर रहे हैं? We are not just studying online, yes. How students are adapting, that means which students we are talking here about? Which students? Yes, so my second parameter would be here, undergraduate students, okay? So I'm making a study on what? Online learning and undergraduate students. ठीक है? अभी ये मेरे दो dominant variables hai, theek hai, abhi online learning my modes can be different, right, my modes can be different, I may using Zoom, I may using Google Meet, I may using Microsoft, or I may using some kind of playing task with the students. And an undergraduate student. Now, मेरे undergraduate students can be FY, can be SY, can be TY. अभी मुझे बताओ किसका किसके ऊपर impact आएगा? Online learning are going to impact students or students are going to impact online learning? Who is going to cause impact on each other? कौन किसके ऊपर impact करेगा? बताओ. Who will impact each other? Online learning will create an impact or undergraduate students will create an impact? Who will create an impact? Online learning impact create karega ya students impact create karenge? Online learning will impact students. Okay, very good, Jainish. Online learning, absolutely. Matlab ye online learning hai, uska impact hum log study kare. Kiske upar study kar rahe? Students ke upar study kare. To mujhe batao, tell me, who will be influencer here? Yahan pe influence kaun kar raha hai? Who is influencing online learning or undergraduate student? Who is influencing? Influence कौन कर रहा है? Who is influencing? Who is influencing here? Yes, online learning is creating an influence. Yes, you all are absolutely right. And who are getting affected? Affect कौन हो रहा है? Who is getting affected or impacted? Absolutely right, Isha. Fine, it's okay. Okay, students are getting affected. ये समझा? कौन affect हो रहा है and कौन impact कर रहा है? There are influencer and there are affector. One factor is influencing, other factor is getting affected. So let's go ahead. Let's go back to the PPT. I'll just go. So that's what I'm talking about, the independent variable and dependent variable. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Independent variable and dependent variable. Independent variable is like independent variable, which is purely as like its name, which is purely having as its independent. It is not getting affected by, it is not going to change. Okay, other variables are going to change because of the presence of independent variable. Matlab main online learning mein Google Meet ka impact, Zoom ka impact, teachers aapke sath online game khelte hai ya nahi khelte hai, okay, this is going to affect, this is going to show whether you are enjoying the learning or you are not going to enjoy the learning, right? Aisa hi hota hai. Ya aapke presence pe upar depend hota hai, teacher dikhayegi ya nahi dikhayegi. Whose role is more important, teaching or learning? Which is more important? When you will enjoy to learn? When you will enjoy to learn? Tell me, when you will enjoy to learn? When you will enjoy learning? When effective teaching. So effective teaching here becomes very strong element. Okay, ye strong element will create impact on students, whether students are going to excel or not. So samjha? To hamare variables mein, if I again go back to our PPT, tell me इंडिपेंडेंट मतलब समझा सबको क्या है? What is mean by independent is clear to you all? Independent variable, also known as absolute variable, which is going to influence. It is an influencer. Some independent variables like gender have fixed number, okay, and it is going to affect others. Independent variable is going to affect others. So if I ask in a PPT, whatever you can see, tell me, online learning is independent or UG students is independent? What is independent? Is online learning independent or UG students are independent? Type in the chat box. My question is, be quick, be quick. मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा आगे जाना है. We are still just on one concept. Who is going to affect? Which is the independent here? Online or UG? Be quick, be quick. Online or UG? Independent. जिसके ऊपर फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा है, जो influence कर रहा है. Who is influencing here? Who is influencing here? Yes, Aishwarya, absolutely right. Who is influencing here? Yes, the other batch? Yes, right, Jainish. Okay, online learning is affecting you. Okay, so that becomes your independent variable. Again, I'll go to my PPT. Okay, so that is what called as independent variable. Who are not affected by anyone, whose presence is going to dominate others, is called as independent variable. And the reverse is called as your dependent variable. Abhi dependent variable is a affector. अफेक्टर मतलब जो अफेक्ट होगा, जिसके ऊपर इन्फ्लुएंस आएगा. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल विल बी डिपेंडेंट ऑन इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल चेंज होगा, डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल भी चेंज होगा. ठीक है, समझा? इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल अगर चेंज होता है, जैसे कि आपके टीचर्स ने ऑनलाइन लर्निंग गेम्स ऑर्गेनाइज किए, वो गेम्स से आपको सीखने में बहुत पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट आया, सो यूर learning is getting affected because of teachers' learning modes, right? So you are getting influenced by, you are getting affected by. So you are a dependent variable, students are dependent variable, and online learning is independent variable. I hope you all got the concept called as what is mean by dependent variable and independent variable, right? One more example, be quick, A study on impact of online learning among undergraduate students of Commerce University of Mumbai. Yahan pe bhi, it's the same example. Actually, it's the same example. Take this example. Tell me, yahan pe kaun sa dependent hai, yahan pe kaun sa independent hai. Be quick. The budget will result in increased opportunity of entrepreneurship in the rural youths. Among rural youths, kiska zyada impact aayega? Who is yahan pe influencing? Yahan pe influencing segment kaun sa hai? Who will create significantly affect? The rural youth is dependent. Okay, who is independent? Yahan pe independent kaun hai? Pehla mera, okay, dependent variable. First dependent variable kaun hai? Dependent. Yes, better you type like that. The variable ka naam and the dependent. So youth is dependent, budget is independent. Very good, very good. And the next batch says what? Youth is dependent. Yes, right, Janice. Youth is dependent and then budget, which is going to affect the employment opportunity, will be your independent. Absolutely right. So you got my point. Absolutely. Clearly, that is what is meant by variable. Yes. We shall move ahead to the next part that is called as sample size. Abhi ye aapne aapke stats mein learn kiya, right? All have learned maths and stats. Yes, yes, students. Aapne maths and stats already learn kiya hai, right? So now sample size is nothing but when we are doing study. Jaise ki aapko ma'am ne bataya tha, picture hai. Kaun sa? Two states. Abhi ye two states movie tha, jisme ye story hai, scripting hai. To usme aapko hero heroine lagte hai. So basically those hero heroine is what? Some are playing significant role, some are playing insignificant role. Hero ke move pe depend hota hai, heroine kaisa move lege. Agar heroine ne ghar choda to hero ko heroine ko leke bhaag hi jana padega. So that is what all about. The variable plays a role in case of your research. Okay. And then sample size. Sample size is about the population. Hum logo jaise maine aapko topic diya tha yahan pe, that study of online learning among undergraduate students of University of Mumbai. अभी मैं University of Mumbai लूँगी तो यहाँ पे हम लोग के पास 20,000 के ऊपर students हैं. We do have 20,000 students who are studying in University of Mumbai. So if I ask you all, more than 20,000 भी हो सकता है. I'm just saying roughly, approximately 20,000 students can be there with University of Mumbai. Assume या 50,000 हो सकता है. चलो पकड़ो 50,000 है. Okay? अब ये 50,000 का पूरा survey करोगे क्या? If I ask you to do a survey of this particular topic, will you be able to survey everybody? Will you be able to survey everyone? Tell me, will you be able to survey everyone? It's not possible, right? I cannot do survey of everyone. So now I have to select a sample from the universe. So jo mera university undergraduate studies ka university ka jo sample universe hai, that population is of 50,000. So 50,000 is called as universe of population. जिसमें से मुझे scrutinize करके I have to take one sample, which is a selected subgroup from the population. 50,000 में से I will survey 5,000 और I may survey 500 as my sample size. उसमें भी मैं categories कर सकती हूँ. That is what about the sample designs जो हम लोग बाद में देखेंगे. Okay? So sample size simply क्या है? Sample size is what? एक n part of the population. N sample representing a population. जैसे 50,000 में से 5,000 लोग I am going to study. That is called as sample size. Very clear? What is meant by sample size? जैसे कि a study on impact of online learning among undergraduate commerce students of University of Mumbai. तो यहाँ पे मैंने specify किया. मेरा sample size क्या होगा? Undergraduate students है, 50,000 students है. Out of which I only want commerce students. So assume करो commerce students है 30,000. अब ये 30,000 में से आई हैव टू कम डाउन अगेन ऑन अ लोअर लेवल. तो मैं कौन सा सैंपल चूज करूं? हाउ शुड वी यूज द सैंपल? यू कैन सी द पिक्चर, राइट? दैट इज व्हाट हाउ द सैंपलिंग इज डन और हाउ द सैंपलिंग इज रिप्रेजेंटेड. इतने पॉपुलेशन में हाउ आई एम गोइंग टू सिलेक्ट द सैंपल? ये भी आपने स्टैट्स में लर्न किया है. स्टिल इट विल बी काइंड ऑफ रिविजन फॉर यू ऑल. सो दीज आर द सैंपलिंग डिजाइन टाइप्स एंड टेक्निक्स विच आर नथिंग बट अ स्ट्रैटेजीज, a tool which will help you to design, which will help you to select your sample according to your need of research. The way you select, the required sampling units from a sampling population for identifying your required sample size. जैसे कि undergraduate commerce students, तो कौन से area के लिए बाबा? I have colleges in South Mumbai, I have colleges in Western Mumbai, Northern part and Western Eastern part. So कौन से colleges के लेना है? For which I have to have some kind of strategy. कि Southern part के 50%, 25%, Eastern के 25%. West ke 25 and Northern ke 25%. So this is how I'm going to arrange. So I have to use some kind of strategy. Aisa bhi ho sakta hai, due to pandemic, I'm not able to reach everywhere. So which tools to be used? So this is a logic or plan to select a sample. This is the way to identify a structured way of selecting sample that is called as sampling design. Samjha sampling design kya hai? Sampling design kya hai? Ek strategy hai to select the sample. जैसे कल आपने डिसाइड किया कि मुझे सर्च करना है कितने लोग मेरा एप्लीकेशन यूज करते हैं. सपोज आपने कल कुछ आपका वेबसाइट स्टार्ट किया एंड यू वांट टू चेक हाउ मेनी पीपल आर यूजिंग योर वेबसाइट. सो फॉर विच यू हैव टू गो रैंडमली. यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू नो विच पीपल आर यूजिंग माई एप्लीकेशन, विच पीपल आर नॉट यूजिंग. सो फॉर विच यू हैव टू यूज सम काइंड ऑफ टेक्निक्स. दैट इज द स्ट्रेटजी टू फ्रेम अ सैम्पल साइज, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ सैम्पलिंग डिजाइन. And then this sampling design is further categorized into qualitative sampling and quantitative sampling. Before I proceed further, I hope I am at smooth pace. I am not too fast. You all are able to understand as the concepts are also very easy. The pace is okay. It's not too fast, right? Yes. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay. Let's move ahead. That is what called as your types of sampling strategies, which are divided into two parts, quantitative and qualitative. The word quantitative and qualitative says what? जहाँ पे मुझे quantum में research करना है, I have to survey a large sample. जैसे कि आपने सुना है population survey होता है, you all know population survey, right? You all know population survey. Population survey में कितना population survey होता है? उसमें लोग sample size लेते हैं क्या? Population survey में कभी sample size लेते हैं? Have you heard about any time population survey में sample size लिया है? Yes, population में कभी sample size लिया है कोई area का? I think my one class is sleeping. It's okay, fine. Okay, so samples, when we doing a national sample survey, at that time there is no sample size. You have to survey everywhere. So there is a quantum of people to be surveyed. तो वहां पे आपका दूसरा स्ट्रेटजी लगेगा, हाउ यू विल बी डूइंग द सर्वे बेस्ड ऑन क्लस्टर. बेस्ड ऑन ये क्लस्टर ही होता है ना, मुंबई में डी वार्ड, साउथ वार्ड, नॉर्थ वार्ड एंड सो ऑन. वी हैव द वार्ड्स अकॉर्डिंगली द सैंपल आर टेस्टेड एंड कलेक्टेड. ओके, तो वो हुआ आपका सैंपलिंग का एक स्ट्रक्चर्ड वे. ओके, सो वैसा ही आपके क्वालिटेटिव सैंपलिंग्स है एंड क्वांटिटेटिव सैंपलिंग मेथड्स है. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द qualitative sampling method, it is a research which is based on the philosophy of empiricism, follow an unstructured pattern, a flexible approach. कि जहाँ पे मुझे restrictions नहीं है, I can do according to my convenience. जैसे मुझे stress level check करना है, stress level among undergraduate student, तो stress level I can check on my own level according to my convenience, to my nearby relatives, my friends, my siblings or any other friends or colleagues who are the other places. According to my flexibility, I'll be doing my research, which can meet the requirement of my topic. So where I need not go by some kind of structured way, where I can have an in-depth understanding of my subject, what I'm looking forward for. So a qualitative sampling hai, which can be used for small sample size. Mujhe chota sample pe test karna hai, I can do the qualitative sampling method, and wherein I can do an in-depth study. Whereas in quantitative sampling, it is more structured way. जैसे मैंने बोला आपको National Sample Survey Organization, NSSSO, who conducts the population survey, which is on a large sample, which is having a greater emphasis on large sample size. तो आपको qualitative we do on small sample size, quantitative we do on a large sample size. Are we clear? मतलब sampling का दो major categories है, which are called as qualitative and one is quantitative. Qualitative we do for qualitative study, behavioral study, जहाँ पे मुझे behavioral study करना है, and the quantitative can be a data where I have to measure कितने लोगों का vaccination हुआ, right? We all are vaccinated. How many of us are vaccinated? So vaccination is a count which I can get to know, and I need a maximum data to be surveyed about कि इतने लोगों का vaccination हुआ, इतने लोगों का vaccination नहीं हुआ. That is my quantitative study, but after vaccination, how many people got affected, kind of effects on health. That is my behavioral study. That is my qualitative study. I hope I'm clear on what is meant by quantitative and what is meant by qualitative. Yes. Am I clear on what is meant by quantitative and what is meant by qualitative? Absolutely fine. Great. Okay, so let's move ahead. Then these are the sampling method. पहले थे आपके types of sampling design. हम लोग designing कैसे लेंगे? On the basis of quantum or on the basis of quality, on the basis of numbers or on the basis of behavioral or some kind of other qualitative terminologies. But which are the techniques? The techniques or the methods of sampling are called as probability sampling method and non-probability sampling method. ये आपने already learn किया है, right? You have already learned called as probability sampling and non-probability sampling. The probability means what? Type in the chat box. What is meant by probability sampling? Do type in the chat box what we know by probability sampling. What is meant by probability sampling? Very simple, very simple. Be quick. Probability means what? A possibility. Yes. Probability means what? Probability sampling method. A possibility. We will take a possibility, we will take a chance. We won't go by a structured way. कि बाबा ऐसे ही जाना है, इतने students को ही survey करना है, ऐसा ही way है. It's not a structured way. That's called as my probability sampling. There is a possibility that every item in population has an equal chance of getting selected. It is called as a probability. We have a chances to get selected into my sample size. Non-probability, there is no structured way. Probability, there is a structured way of selecting the sample. Okay, probability means what? There is a structured way, and non-probability is what? There is no structured way. There is a convenience which is given in case of non-probability. So when we talk about a probability method, there are further types, which is your simple random sampling. Simple random sampling means what? Every case, that is every nth thing. जैसे आपके lottery में होता है, particular number of what happened? Every sample has an yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Vinaya ma'am. I just ignored this chat box. Yes. Okay. So wherein simple random sampling. Every case of the population has an equal probability to get selected, like lottery method. Every 10th, every 100, randomly किसी को. या हम लोग shop में जाते हैं. You are a lucky winner. Okay. Lucky winner on the basis of what? Every 100 customer or every 1,000 customer of ours, you are a privileged customer, so you will be getting selected. So this is what a kind of structure which is given. There is simple random sampling. Then it's just stratified. When we say stratified matlab a strata. Strata matlab a group. Okay, so stratified sampling is where the population is divided into strata or subgroups, and a random sample is taken randomly. Usme se log select karte hai. So first there are groups created. जैसे मैंने सैंपल डिसाइड किया अंडर ग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मुंबई. सो यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मुंबई में सदर्न पार्ट के, ईस्टर्न पार्ट के, नॉर्दर्न पार्ट के एंड वेस्टर्न पार्ट के, दैट इज माय सब ग्रुप्स, एंड आउट ऑफ विच आई कैन सिलेक्ट रैंडमली एनी स्टूडेंट. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज स्ट्रैटिफाइड रैंडम सैंपलिंग. आर वी क्लियर ऑन स्ट्रैटिफाइड रैंडम सैंपलिंग? आर वी क्लियर ऑन स्ट्रैटिफाइड रैंडम सैंपलिंग? सिंपल तो सबको पता है. स्ट्रैटिफाइड मीन्स वॉट? एक ग्रुप्स को सिलेक्ट करना है एज पर आवर स्टडी ऑनलाइन education among undergraduate students. So when I say undergraduate commerce students from Southern College, Western College, Eastern College and Northern College, right? Okay, let's move ahead. That's called as that is based on strata. Any segment can be selected. And then come is your cluster sampling. Cluster matlab area based. Cluster matlab kya hai? Area based division. When the population is scattered, at that time you need to create a cluster region wise. That is called as cluster sampling. Okay, when it is used, it is advantageous for those researchers whose subjects are fragmented over a large geographical areas. That is called as we use cluster sampling. Jaise ki how many of undergraduate students who are doing research where they have received a patent for their research. Abhi patent wale students University of Mumbai mein exclusive nahi honge. So for which I may go for all over India ka different universities, and from which I will be deciding from eastern region, from western part of India, northern part of India and southern part of India. I'll be selecting the people, the students who are received the patent. So this is when my universe is scattered, I have to go for cluster sampling. Am I clear? when we go for cluster sampling, jab mera population scattered hai, I go for cluster sampling. Jaise ki kisne research kiya hai, jisko patent mila hai. Aise log bahut kam hota hai students mein. To mere agar university mein out of 50,000, I only have 10 students who got a patent or 5 students who got a patent. To 5 logon se main research nahi kar sakti. I cannot do a research with the 5 students alone in case of undergraduate courses of Mumbai. So I have to go with undergraduate courses of Pune University, Allahabad University, Delhi University, Haryana University, Kashmir University, and so on. So this is what my cluster. Are you all getting my points? Are you all there? Kindly revert. Okay, okay, great, fine. Okay, that is what we are cluster. And then comes the systematic sampling. Systematic sampling, the word says what? It is a every nth case will get a random selection. Okay, that is called as a systematic sampling. For example, I want to select students from SY batch. So I have SYA, I have SYB. I have SYA BMS, SYB BMS, SYA BAF, SYB BAF, SYA banking, and so on. So from every batch, every 20th student will be selected as a representative. That is called as my systematic sampling. Clear? Very easy to understand systematic sampling. Then we will move to the last, is your multi-stage. Multi-stage matlab main ek method use kar sakti hu ya main all methods use kar sakti hu for different label. Okay, that is called as your multi-stage sampling, wherein the process moving from a broad to a narrow sample using step-by-step process, that is called as multi-stage sampling. That is all about your probability sampling method. Are we clear on probability sampling method? Probability sampling method. Okay. Then let's move to the non-probability. Non-probability matlab random, guess, convenient, comfort, flexibility. It is called as your non-probability. Sampling is often associated with case study research or some kind of particular qualitative research wherein we use non-probability sampling. Non-probability kahan pe use karte hai? Jahan pe behavioral study ya qualitative study karna hai, we use non-probability method. So there is on small sample size we can do non-probability, but the statistical inferences are not to be made on larger population, we use non-probability. So non-probability mein I am very clear about who can be my exactly what I am looking forward for. So no need to be representative of a random or a particular area. In which we have a quota sampling. Quota sampling is a non-random sampling method wherein each participant are chosen on the basis of predetermined characteristic. Ki baba, itne logon mein se 10 log select honge. Har class mein se koi bhi 10 log. No random. From division A, any 10 students. From division B, any 10 students. So that is what? A random selection from the group. That is called as quota sampling. Then we have a snowball sampling. Snowball sampling is what? Again, one more non-random sampling method where is a use of few cases to help to encourage the other cases to take a part in the study. In this, small population are difficult to access due to the close nature and it is inaccessible. So where sample size is very rare to find and we can use some kind of references here. Again, I take the example of undergraduate courses, commerce students with the HIV positive. Can I get HIV positive students who are getting undergraduate courses in the University of Mumbai? Can we find that sample easily? Can we find any student who is HIV positive and who is taking undergraduate course from University of Mumbai? Can we get that sample size easily available? Yes, here it's very difficult, right? So for which I have to go with some kind of references. So I may give a call to one of my friend into other college. Do you have any such kind of students? Or I may say handicapped students. So handicapped students, har college mein bhar bhar ke handicapped students nahi hote hai. So I may give a call to my friends that do you have any handicapped students? So accordingly, I will do my survey. It may be a part of my study that I want to check the online learning impact on handicapped students. So this is what? A snowball sampling method. Okay. And then the judgment sampling method will come. Judgment sampling is the judgment of researcher. Okay, it is a strategy wherein particular settings or persons or events selected intentionally. Intentionally, main wo mere judgment ke hisab se, mere perception ke hisab se, mere thoughts ke hisab se, on the basis of my intuitions, I'll be selecting sample because I believe these are the people who can give a genuine answers. Jaise mujhe survey karna hai mere class ka hai, mere college ka. Okay, I'll be selecting CRs because I know that CRs are the people who do attend the sessions, who are regular on the lectures and who can give a genuine feedback. Okay, they will not be bluffing. So this is my judgment sampling. On the basis of my judgment, I'll be selecting my sample. And the last part is called as my convenience sampling. I'm so sorry. Convenience sampling. Convenience sampling, the name itself says that it's purely based on the convenience of the researcher. Researcher ko jaisa convenient lage, uske flexibility ke hisab se, he or she is going to select the sample. So there is no logic. So convenience sampling mostly often helping to overcome the problems or the limitations which can be associated with some of the research. Jaisa ki, many of the students who were conducting their research during the pandemic lockdown, jab initially kiya tha, at that time it was very strict. For that time, they had a limitation ki unko wo survey karne hi the. They had to come down on the road, but they were not able to do it. So for which they went on a convenience sampler. According to their convenience, they selected the sample randomly. Okay, that is called as your non-probability sampling method. Convenience of researcher to select the sample or source. Are we clear on sampling methods? Are we clear on sampling methods? Any doubts? Any doubts? Very clear? Okay, I hope I have not made you all much bored. Then we will go to the next concept, a small concept which talks about, this is what I have done about, very sorry. Okay, then comes is your pilot study or pilot study. People do call it as pilot study, people do call it as pilot study, the way you want to call it. But basically this is again very integral part of your research. One has to do their pilot study before they conduct the research. Mujhe aapne population testing ya market testing suna hai. Have you ever heard about market testing? Have you ever heard about market testing? Before product gets launched into the market, few sample lete hai and then they check the consumer behavior. Log kaise respond karte hai and accordingly I can launch my product into the market. Okay, similarly, whether my research is applicable or not, whether my research is workable or not, whether my questions, whether my questionnaire which I have designed, hum log questionnaire kaise design karne wo baad mein dekhenge, to check basically the feasibility of my study, feasibility of my research, whether my objectives are right or not, my hypothesis is right or not, whatever I have framed the questions, are they able to understand by that particular sample or not, for which I will be doing a sample study. And that sample study is nothing but small population where I will do a testing, that is called as pilot study. Before actual circulation of a questionnaire, we do conduct pilot study and it helps and saves the researcher from landing to failures or landing to falling in some kind of problems or some kind of failures. Unka research fail ho sakta hai, research effective nahi ho sakta, product fail ho sakta hai, for which we do conduct pilot study. Are we clear? Are we clear what is mean by pilot study? Next and I think last part of our topic for the day, that is a research design. Now research design is something, is nothing but jab bhi main research karti hu, I may have an idea into my mind ki baba mujhe kya karna hai, jaise ki online learning impact on undergraduate student, this is into my mind, but how should I flow about it? Mujhe kaise jana hai, kaise research karo, kya flow hoga, first what should I do, first or should not I do? There is something called as blueprint. Have you heard about the word blueprint? Have you have heard about the word blueprint? Blueprint kahan pe suna hai aapne? Blueprint kahan pe suna hai aapne? Where you have heard about blueprint? Where you have heard about blueprint? Kahan pe suna hai? Jaldi bolo, jaldi bolo. Where you have heard about blueprint? Blueprint kahan pe suna hai aapne? Where you have heard the word blueprint? Making of design. Yes. Builder ke paas suna, builder ke paas dekha hoga blueprints. That they have an image before construction of the building. So if they have their plant ready, they can, like selling pehle hi hota hai builders ka. So how they sell, based on what? Based on the blueprint, people do select ki mujhe ye chahiye, ye chahiye. I want this particular room or this is the particular room and accordingly I'll be choosing. So it makes me a better decision making. Or from the builder's point of view, he is very crystal clear about usko process kaise karna hai. First floor pe washroom area kahan pe hoga, किचन एरिया कहाँ पे होगा, सो लिफ्ट कैन बी फ्लोर फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अदर प्लेस, सो हाउ थिंग्स कैन बी, सो ही और शी गेट एन एडिक्वेट प्री ऑक्यूपाइड पिक्चर इनटू द माइंड इनिशियली ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ ब्लूप्रिंट, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट अ रिसर्च डिजाइन. रिसर्च डिजाइन इज ऑल्सो सिमिलर टू अ ब्लूप्रिंट. इट इज अ प्रोसीजरल प्लान दैट इज अडॉप्टेड बाय द रिसर्चर टू आंसर द क्वेश्चंस. It helps to check the validity, objectivity, accuracy and economical viability. जैसे कई बार ना बड़े बड़े रिसर्च होते हैं, जैसे आप जब अंडर ग्रेजुएट हो जाओगे, when you be graduate, when you be post graduate, or some of you when you want to do some kind of research for your company, company पे भी रिसर्च होता है, आपको पता है? You all might be involved into, ये जो हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं वो एक रिसर्च थीसिस के बारे में हुआ, but definitely when we go to the company, we will be doing research for company, and for which company do put some kind of funds, पैसा होता है, crores of पैसा होता है, lakhs of rupees होता है. जैसे आपका मेट्रो का प्लान है, यू ऑल आर अवेयर अबाउट मेट्रो प्लान, राइट? मेट्रो प्लान, मेट्रो ट्रेन, मोनो ट्रेन, बुलेट ट्रेन एंड सो मेनी. ये आइडियाज थे पहले दिमाग में कि हम लोग के इंडिया को एडवांस कैसे बनाने का, सुपर नेशनल कंट्री कैसे बनाने का, सुपर पावर कंट्री कैसे बनाने का. सो दीज आर द थॉट्स इनटू द माइंड ऑफ सीएम्स और मिनिस्टर्स. तो उसको प्लान बनाने के लिए दे क्रिएटेड अ ब्लूप्रिंट कि ये कहाँ से स्टार्ट होगा, कहाँ पे जाएगा. ठीक है, जैसे अभी दे हैड अ प्रॉब्लम कि मेट्रो कार चालू होगा तो मेट्रो का कार शेड कहाँ पे होगा. सो इनिशियली दे सिलेक्टेड आरए, देन दे वेंट टू द सेंट्रल पार्ट एंड अगेन दे केम बैक टू द आरए. सो दिस इज हाउ इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द प्लानिंग, बिफोर वी इम्प्लीमेंट द पिक्चर, बिफोर वी इम्प्लीमेंट द रिसर्च, वी नीड टू हैव दिस थिंकिंग इन आवर माइंड रेडी. ओके, सो थ्रू अ रिसर्च डिजाइन यू डिसाइड फॉर यूर सेल्फ एंड कम्युनिकेट टू द अदर्स यूर डिसीजन रिगार्डिंग वॉट एग्जैक्टली यू आर डूइंग, वाई यू आर डूइंग, how you are going to do, how you are going to collect the information. So this is why we do have a research design. So it is an advanced planning of the methods. Main random sampling use karungi, probability use karungi, non-probability use karungi, which can be my variables, okay, where I can study what, that all will be, I will be deciding in advance. So for better economical, attractive construction of a house, we need a blueprint. Similar way, it is prepared by an expert and architect. Similar way, we create it for our research purpose. It is called as your research design. Are we clear on what is mean by research design? Are we clear on what is mean by research design? Kyun important hai? Aap itna mehnat karoge. Jaise ki jab aap sab log bhi shayad SY mein ho. You all will go in your TY. Wo TY mein aapko 100 marks ka project hai. At that time also you need some in hand, mere dimag mein hona chahiye. Ki main readymade uthane wali hu ya main banane wali hu. If I'm making ready or if I'm making out my own, how I'm going to do work. हम लोग जब पिकनिक प्लान करते हैं वो टाइम भी हम लोग को रिसर्च डिजाइन ही बनाते हैं. वी डू हैव अ प्लान इन माइंड कि मेरा प्लान ए वर्क नहीं हुआ तो मेरे पास प्लान बी है, प्लान बी में प्रॉब्लम हुआ तो वी हैव प्लान सी. इट इज नथिंग बट अ ब्लूप्रिंट इन एडवांस प्रिपरेशन सो दैट इन केस सम काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स कम, इन सम काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन कम वेयर वी आर नॉट एबल टू इम्प्लीमेंट आवर प्लान इफेक्टिवली, देन वी हैव अ प्लान बी इन आवर हैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ रिसर्च डिजाइन. ओके, लेट्स मूव अहेड. I hope I'm not too fast. Again, I'm asking the same question. I'm not too fast, right? You all are able to understand, right? Okay, thank you. Thank you for the patience. Trust me, second last PPT, last PPT hai ye. Iske baad thank you hai aur uske baad question and answer hai. So kindly be cooperative. Thank you, Shrida. Be cooperative, have patience and listen very carefully. Okay, let's move ahead. So types of research design. These are the set of research design. Exploratory research design, descriptive research design, experimental and explanatory. ये बनाया मैम ने आपको already बताया है, but still I'll just revise it. Okay? When we say exploratory, the word exploratory means what? क्या लगता है? Exploratory means क्या होगा? What can be exploratory? Be quick. Last 10 minutes है मेरे पास. Exploratory means क्या? To explore. What we explore? When we explore something, what we have in our mind? Explorable things मतलब क्या होगा वहाँ पे? What we explore usually? हम लोग explore क्या कहना चाहते हैं? Usual things या unusual things? What we explore usually? Something new, कुछ नया करना है and we explore, right? So exploratory research will fall into the areas. Yes, thank you, Vinaya ma'am. Very good students. Yes. Okay, so exploratory is what? I'm searching something new. I want to investigate something new. Okay, so this is when a study is undertaken with the objective either to explore a new area where little is known or to investigate something possibilities, undertaking some kind of research studies. When a study is carried out to determine the feasibility is also called as, यहाँ पे आप pilot study भी कर सकते हैं explore करने के लिए मेरा app market में चलेगा या नहीं चलेगा. Best example is the example of vaccination. सबको vaccination दिया, vaccination के पहले वहाँ पे test हुए गए थे. You know, अभी भी some of the vaccination, they are saying some of the vaccination are applicable, accepted in European countries, some of the vaccinations are accepted into US and so on. So to check the viability, to check whether it is accessible, worth or not, feasible or not, we do exploratory research. Or once finalized, we can implement it effectively. Okay, that is what called as your exploratory research. These studies are usually more appropriate in case of problem. When we have a problem and when we have a less knowledge, COVID aaya, China ne COVID India mein bheja. China, because of China, COVID was spread all over the globe. Everybody started evaluating what are the reasons. And abhi bolte hain, hum log COVID has become a mutant. Unka mutations change hote rehta hai. So this is what out of exploration people are getting to know about. That is called as exploratory research. Okay? Very good. Next comes your descriptive research. The word says is what descriptive. Descriptive matlab kya hoga? Descriptive matlab, it is in depth. It is in detail. इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं स्टैटिस्टिकल रिसर्च. दिस डिस्क्राइब द फिनोमेनन इन डिटेल. हम लोग यहाँ पे उसका पोस्टमार्टम करते हैं, क्या हुआ, कब हुआ, कैसे हुआ. ओके, इट इज कॉल्ड एज डिस्क्रिप्टिव. इट इज यूज्ड टू आइडेंटिफाई एंड ऑब्टेन द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर इश्यू लाइक अ कम्युनिटी ग्रुप और अ पीपल. इन अदर वर्ड्स, दिस टाइप ऑफ रिसर्च डिस्क्राइब्स सोशल इवेंट, सोशल स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, द ऑब्जर्वर ऑब्जर्व एंड डिस्क्राइब्स व्हाट हैपेंड, हाउ हैपेंड, व्हाई हैपेंड. It is used to study the current situation in detail. Jaise ki Delta variant, third wave, people will be describing in detail. Kya facts hai, kya figures hai, and accordingly, they will be studying on the scene. It is more commonly used in social sciences or socio-economic surveys, where and job and activity analysis. The descriptive research aims at portraying accurately the characteristics of a particular group or a situation. Okay, wherein it is more concerned about the attitude of the viewers or the person towards XYZ thing, the capital punishment, the prohibition, or the college autonomy, or some kind of transgender, or some kind of removing reservation or keeping reservation. These are what descriptive studies, which can be done on the basis of statistical ways. Next comes your experimental research design. Experimental research design, which is experiment, kind of a laboratory, wherein you are checking the cause and effect. What happened? Why happened? One event is keeping effect, or one particular factor is causing effect on others. So it is studying the casualties when a researcher or someone else introduced the intervention that is assumed to be the cause of change and waits until that produces some kind of effect. So to check the cause and effect relationship, we do which research? Experimental research. Absolutely right, you all are. Descriptive was about the detail. I just didn't check your very good, Jainish. Yes, everybody is actively participating. Very good. Okay, then your cause and effect, we basically check here is your cause and effect relationship in case of experimental. Okay, the research design is usually used to check the cause and effect relationship. We should remember that an experiment is an observation under controlled condition. जैसे हम लोग सर्टन फैक्टर्स को इग्नोर करते हैं इन केस ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटल, जैसे कि कोविड का वैक्सीनेशन, वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट द पर्सन इज बीइंग नॉर्मल एंड देन चेकिंग वेदर इट इज हैविंग अ पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट और नेगेटिव इफेक्ट. एक नॉर्मल बंदे ने अगर वैक्सीनेशन लिया तो उसको सादा सा एक बुखार आके जाएगा, इट इज वेरी एब्सोल्युटली फाइन. या वो थोड़ा एरिया रेडिश होगा या उसको थोड़ा स्वेलिंग होगा, एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल. बट व्हेन आई से आई एम इग्नोरिंग द अजम्पशंस दैट वुड फॉल अंडर अदर स्टडीज. So when, जब मैं एक्सपेरिमेंटल बोलती हूँ वहां पे assumptions आते हैं, the factors are very controlled over here, okay? And then the last part is about your explanatory research. Explanatory research, it is explanatory in detail why and how the relationships are there, what, wow, why, how, when, all things will be detailed explained. It is called as explanatory. डिस्क्रिप्टिव में हम लोग क्वेश्चन को आंसर करेंगे, क्या हुआ, कैसे हुआ. एक्सप्लेनेटरी एक कॉन्सेप्ट को लेके, जैसे कि फॉर इंस्टेंस रिसर्च ऑन वायलेंस अगेंस्ट ब्लूम कंडक्टेड बाय वन ऑफ द ऑथर डिस्क्राइब नॉट ओनली वैरायटीज ऑफ वायलेंस व्हिच कैन हैपन विद द ह्यूमंस बट ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन व्हाई इट हैपेंस, व्हिच आर द डिफरेंट रीजंस. ओके, एंड दैट इज डिटेल्ड एक्सप्लेनेशन. जैसे कि एक्सप्लॉयटेशन वायलेंसेस ऑफ किडनैपिंग, व्हाई हैपन, हाउ हैपन, व्हेन हैपन, and what are the remedies for the same. That is what explanatory evaluates the relationship among different variable. That is called as explanatory type of research. Are we clear on different type of research? More exaggerated, yes, in more detail. Very good, very good. Okay, So this is all about today's concepts which we have learned. I am done with the concepts. Any kind of questions we have? Any kind of questions we do have? I hope you all are cleared with all the kind of basic concepts of research. Huh? These were the very basic concepts. Tomorrow also we'll be putting light on some of the concepts like objective and hypothesis. Any doubts, please do ask. Thank you, Shruti. Okay, if not, then I think we can wind up then.
Yes, madam, no questions.
Yeah, Sonal ma'am. Sorry, Sonal ma'am, Pooja ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
We can conclude it.
Done? Yeah, students ma'am. Don't have any answers. Questions?
No.
Sorry. Okay then we'll wind up. Okay. Sorry, I didn't get you.
No, I'm just seeing the attainments.
Okay. Thank you, Sheetal madam, and thank you, Vinaya madam, for so much of informative and knowledge sessions you have provided to the students. I really feel that they must have gained so much of knowledge regarding the research, and also it proved to be a value added knowledge to their, whatever the knowledge they had, maybe it was a value added knowledge to their existing one. Yes, students, do you agree with me? Did you enjoy the session? Okay, so I really thank you all the students, all the participants who have maintained the decor and also the discipline. Thank you so much again for your, so keep up the same spirit tomorrow, that is day two. So we will definitely meet tomorrow at the same time with the same spirit and with the same enthusiasm. Okay, before you leave, don't forget to fill up the feedback form. I'll be just putting, yes, spirits high. I'll just putting the link in the chat box in 2 minutes. Okay.
Thank you so much for active participation and yes, being interactive. And thank you, Vinaya ma'am, for cooperating. Thank you, Rishabh, also. Thank you so much for the coordination and cooperation and being active. Yes, Vinaya ma'am, you can take ahead.
Thank you, Sheetal madam. Thank you, all the students. Thank you very much.
And thank you, Sonal ma'am, too, and Pooja ma'am.